So everybody, most of them, well, you, most of them have done very well in computer science exam. Very good. And today we are going to see the next lesson. Maybe if you have textbook with you, please take out. Turn to page number 97. So the lesson name, formatting in MS PowerPoint. I know everybody mastering in creating presentation, but still yet to know some concept, okay? So with that, you can make your presentation in better manner. So that's what we are going to do, some formatting on our presentation. Shall we get into the lesson now? Yes, ma, yes. Yes. So first, what is mean by formatting? So we know already, we have studied in Microsoft Word what is mean by formatting. So the arrangement of text in Microsoft Word, like that we studied in Word. So here we are going to same formatting. So what is mean by the word formatting? The process of arranging. Maybe you can arrange text or picture or some of the elements what we have studied, right? PowerPoint. Maybe the elements called text, picture, audio, video, graphics, animation, everything we are going to arrange in certain format. So, okay. So the arrangement, the process of arrangement of all your elements in your slide called formatting. Okay, children. So Mahesh, mute your video. Okay, children. So now we are going to arrange something. So this call formatting. Okay. So first one, in that we are going to study change slide layout. Okay. Before that, you must know what is mean by layout. So layout is nothing but some design. Okay. So what is mean by layout? Layout is design. So you can say the layout means the process of arranging your text or picture. I will tell you how to create layouts. Okay, so using this particular layout, you can change content screen, title screen, and all the elements, places. Okay, everything you can change. So we can arrange and reorder the information on your slide using slide layout. Okay, so formatting is nothing but arrangement of your element, and slide layout is nothing but the process of arranging text or picture, maybe all animation elements. Okay, maybe audio, video, graphics, everything included in that. So slide layout, what is mean by slide layout? With that, we can arrange your title screen and content screen, and then information, arranging order of information on your slide with the help of this slide layout. Okay, so we'll get into lesson now. So for this changing slide layout, we have to move. See, just click on the home tab. Before implementing this slide layout, you just select the slide which you need to apply particular slide layout. Okay, you just select the slide. So I'm going to implement slide layout to my third slide. See, in the left side, you can see all the small slides available in the left hand side of your main screen. And you can find I'm going to implement slide layout on my third slide. So I have selected this. Then the particular slide will opening on the main screen, right? So it does. Next one, go to the slide whose layout we want to change. So completed. Now move to home tab, and from the slide group, okay, see here you can find layout icon. So this is the layout icon, children. Okay, near that you can find one drop down small arrow. Just click on the arrow. You will get 9 types of slide layout. Okay, so with that you can change your screen, title screen and the content screen, then order of, that means reorder of information, everything. So suppose in this particular slide I need only title and content, so I can take this, or else you are not going to fix any animation graphics over there. So you can take only title, and if you need two more elements, two more graphical elements based on one particular slide, you can take this two content slide layout option. Okay, if you don't want to fix any element, but you can create your own element and fix with the help of this blank slide layouts. Okay, so these are all the slide layout which will help us to change the title screen and content screen. Then you can reorder your information based on your requirement. Understood, ma? So now moving to the next one, applying themes. So I have done some cartoon backgrounds here for you. For example, I have done some cartoon backgrounds. So in case if you want to apply one plain background, you can move to themes option. Okay, where to find this theme option? So just select the slide where you want to apply. So after selecting slide, click the design tab. From that you can find themes group. See here, themes group, you can find the themes group here. You just click more arrow option available here inside the theme group. Then you can find such a lot of options, theme gallery available inside. Select the theme and apply to your slide. Okay, so after this, see, I have selected, then the particular thing will display on your screen. Okay, so here I have selected my own style. See, you can find on my third slide. Okay children, so this will be called applying themes. So what is mean by theme? First, theme is the collection of visual appealing design elements. So what is mean by the word visually? Visually means something you are seeing on the screen, right? So called visually. A theme is a collection of visually appealing design elements, okay, that you can apply to all the slides in your presentation. Maybe all the slides, or you can apply some slides that you have selected. Understood? So what is mean by the word theme? Theme is the collection of design elements available on that. Okay, so a theme has basic four elements. So four basic component having inside the theme, you can find here. So go to design tab. So after selecting the theme, you can find four components available inside. The first one is called color, and second one font, third one design effects, fourth one background style. So these are all the components available inside your theme. So based on this color option, see Emma, you can set to your slide, right, background, different color schemes available here inside. So based on your requirement, you can choose your own color scheme. Okay, see here, Apex. So based on your requirement, you can select the color scheme available inside the theme. Okay, suppose you have selected the theme is okay for you. Okay, the design is okay, but you want to change color alone, you can move to this color component to change color of your selected theme. Okay children, so the theme is okay and color is okay. Now I want to change the font inside the slide, so you can move to this font option to change your font type, font style alone. Okay, so something you have selected, some theme, whatever you have liked, you have selected. See, I have liked this, so I have selected this. After selecting, I need to change little bit color combination, so that I moved to this color scheme option to change color of my theme. So I have selected now, then everything okay, theme is okay, color scheme is okay. Then I want to change my font style, so that we can move to font component available inside this design tab. See, with that we can change or font. So I have changed. Okay, now you can see this effect option, right, ma? So with the help of effect option, you can implement some effects to your theme. Next one, see clarity. So each and everything different. Next one, background styles. See a simple background available, you can change plain background, okay? And if you need to create by your own, you can move to format background option, and in that soon it will display one dialog box. See a solid fill. So only one color, you can select only one color. Selected, and you can adjust the brightness and darkness over here. And next one, gradient fill. So with that you can make shiny. See here, so everything pre-formatted already. They have done preset background colors. These are all called preset background colors, already defined. And here you can change the direction of the shadows. See here, the color combination, shadow towards top to bottom or bottom to top, and here left to right. Okay, so here horizontally, from, so horizontal thing, this one vertical. You can find the color combination coding part from top to bottom. Okay children, so these are all the different preset colors available. With that you can change, and here you have more color option within the theme color. Using that too, you can change so many color combinations. See here, suppose I need orange color. See here, you cannot find orange, but combination of yellow and red will get orange color, right? So just select on that and you can find orange color in that. So like that, you can apply simple, that means plain background color to your presentation. And if you need to make texture, that means some tiles, we can find this texture on our tile, home tiles. So you can use this whenever needed. See, suppose I have selected this like a marble, that you can apply for your background of your slide. And here so many patterns available, line patterns, everything line patterns. From the line they have designed some patterns, and you can change the foreground. Foreground means outline, okay, the line color. Background means background of the line color. So everything you can change. And if you need to apply to all the slide, you just click apply to all, or else if you don't want, you just close the window and come out. Understood, right, ma? Now, so here we are going to know the important one. There are two ways to get animate your slide. First one, we are going to animate our slide first. For that, definitely we should move slide transition. Okay, for animating your slide, you have to move slide transition. Animating your text, elements, whatever you have fixed within the slide, for that we can move custom animation. Understood? So for animating this particular slide alone, where to move slide transition. So everything available within the slideshow option available here. So where is the slideshow option? You can find, see a transition. First one, we are going to implement some animation to your slides. So for that, where to go? Transition, slide transition. Then you can find transition to the slide. So soon you will get, see, after clicking on the particular transition, you can view the preview on the slide. See? Okay, so I have selected this for my slide. So slide transition always help us to give animation to your slide when it is moving on the presentation. Okay. And next one, we are going to apply some animation technique to your text. For that, where to go? Definitely custom animation is the option. For that, So custom animation. So you can find custom animation inside the slideshow. See here. So slideshow having, and within that you can find the custom show. Before displaying this, you must do some animation for your text. So you just select the text and apply the animation. See here. So I have selected text, float in, fly in. So whatever you need, you can apply. Spin. Okay, so I have applied. Now you can move custom animation or slideshow view. See, now whatever you have done, you can find the same on the screen. Okay, if you need to apply for all the slide, you can give apply to all, or else you just select the particular slide and change the custom animation, then slide transition, everything. Understood, right, ma? So see, select this, and this will be for slide. Now animation for your, okay, now you can find difference. See, so this is the way you have to complete your presentation. Understood? Now moving to next one, adding footers. Just turn to page number 102. There you can find adding footers. So adding header and footer, already we studied in Microsoft Word. Why should we need to add a header or footer? If you need some text to be displayed on all the pages. Okay, so here I have 5, 6 slides, right, ma? So all the 6 slides, I need the slide number, so that I can use either header or footer to represent my slide number, maybe on top or maybe down. Suppose you are going to create one particular lesson presentation, that means one particular topic, so that the topic should be displayed on all the pages, right? For that you can select header and footer. Something you want to display on the top, must select header. Something you want to display in the footer for all the slide, you can select footer. So this option you can get avail from insert tabs. Just click on the insert tab, then you can find header and footer option within the text group. Click on this, soon you will get the dialog box header and footer. Here you can apply date and time if you need. Okay, then slide number. So every slides definitely display with the help of slide number, so that only you can identify the particular slide. So just make a checkbox, tick in the checkbox, and next one, footer. So with the help of footer, we can display some information, some text to all the slides down. Okay, so now I'm going to display all the slides down. Grade 7 PPTX. Okay, so this text I need to display all my slides where? In down. So that I have selected a footer here. So given, next page, next tab, you can find notes and handouts. Here you have header option. So from that you can display some selected text to all your slides in the top. Okay, so here grade 7 presentation. Okay, so then apply to all. Then the thing applied to all the slides. So see here, first slide, see here down what we have given, ma? Grade 7 PPTX, and you can find the slide number on the top. And next slide, see, every slide you can find the slide number, and then footer, what we have typed, right? See, so this is how you can complete your header and footer. So header will help us to display some text on the top of all your slides, and footer will help us to display some text at the bottom for all the slides. And next one, adding notes to slide. So why should we have to add some notes? Because with the help of this notes, you can refer during a presentation. Maybe you can forget. So for what you have created this presentation. So that time, this notes option will help you to refer something during a presentation. Understood? And these notes act as a reminder for the creator who has created this presentation, right? For them, it is acting as the reminder. Understood, right, ma? So with that, you can identify, you can understand for what you have created this particular slide. For that, definitely we should include notes in the slides. Okay, see here, this slide particularly I have created for cartoon. So something, so I can type here for what, whenever. So maybe you just think about here only 6 slides. Consider maybe 100 slides you have created in the presentation. Definitely you will get confused on that when during a presentation, right? So that you must make a notes for what you have created this particular slide. Okay. So this will be acting as a reminder of the creator. Who is creator? Who's creator? The presentation, who has prepared this presentation, called creator. So that it is acting as a reminder of what we want to talk about in particular slide. Understood, ma? So definitely we should use the notes, slide notes. So where to go? Go to the slide where you want to add the notes. Just select the slide alone and click the white space. See here, and you can find the notes pane at the bottom of each slide. Just type the required text in the notes pane and everything will help you to make a reminder for what you have created this particular slide. Understood, right? See, whatever I have created here, it will display. So during my presentation, it will display so that I can refer my point and I can explain to viewers. Understood, ma? Now moving to the next one, slide master. So this is very important thing, and if you know this about slide master, you can avoid the maximum utilization time. So somebody is doing maybe 1 hour, 2 hours creating one simple presentation, so you can avoid everything if you know the concept slide master. So with that, you can change to all the slides of your presentation. You can make changes to all the slides of the presentation in easy manner. So using slide master, we can select the format for title, we can select the background, we can select the color, we can select the date and time option, we can select the slide number. If you applied one particular slide, then everything the same changes definitely will reflect on all the slides. Understood, right, ma? So now we are moving to see about slide master. So where to go for the slide master? Definitely you should move to view tab. So inside you can find the slide master within the master view option. Just click on the slide master. Soon you will get this window. Okay, so here just an additional slide master. See here, you can find inside the slide master tab, one additional slide master tab available soon after pressing slide master option within the presentation view. See, this is new tab. After pressing the slide master, you can view the new tab available on your screen. Okay, then you can find the left hand side, all the slides will be displayed in the left hand side of your master slide. So whatever you have done changes here will reflect on all the slides. See, suppose I'm going to create grade 7 PPTX for formatting in MS PowerPoint. Okay, so completed, and you can change text style and color, everything here. So whatever you have done here will reflect on the screen. So after completing all the changes, you just close this master view, then you can find the same content available on all the text. So grade 7 PPTX formatting. So we have done, right, ma? So you can find in all the slides. See, whatever we have done within the master slide, the same thing you can find in all the slides which you have created. See, you can find, right? See, understood? So that slide master will help us to make changes to all the slides of your presentation. You can change format for your title. Okay, you can change the format. See, click on this. Where to go and get slide master option? You just click view tab and you can find slide master. You can apply some styles for your text. See here, everything available, colors, fonts, everything. So whatever you have selected from this will reflect on all the slides. No need to do each and every slides individually again and again. If you have created everything here using this master slide, everything, whatever changes you have done, definitely will reflect on all the slides. Maybe your title format or your background style or color of your text, background of your text, and the date and the time format, slide number for all the slides. You can fix everything using this slide master, then definitely the same changes will reflect all the slides which you have created. Understood? So these are all the major important thing creating master slide. Understood, right, ma? So we have created and closed. Now see, whatever I have done changes on the master slide definitely will reflect on my all the other slides. No need to do this changes again and again each slide individually. Okay, so wasting time. Instead of that, we can use slide master to change everything. Understood, ma? So we have completed this lesson. Next lesson will be very interesting lesson because we are getting into Microsoft Excel, and this lesson, using this lesson, you just create one simple presentation stating about you. Okay, I have told you how to create animation for your slide as well as your elements which you have inserted within the slide. Everything I told you, just do it. Those who have computer, please try and do it. Understood, right, ma? So next class we are moving to study new interesting lesson. Thank you, children. Take care. Bye.